Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangam University, India. Okay, today, PIPS, Fourier Transform Lecture. Today's topic is Fourier Transform of Aperiodic Basic Signals. Aperiodic means not periodic, basic signals. Then in my lecture 25, I already introduced the formulas of a Fourier transform. Let me review one more times. And here, x over omega, the Fourier transform of x over t is like this. And also inverse Fourier transform of x omega called x over t is like this. This is a continuous case and also discrete case also. Fourier transform of x of n is represented by this x as x omega, and inverse Fourier transform of x omega represented by this as x of n, and also for this we need very useful formula of this integrations. Now this is, you know, 1 by a by e power x. In this case, this is 2 pi delta a. This is a very useful integral formula. Okay, let me take some the examples for Fourier transform and the inverse Fourier transform. First, x of t equal delta function. As you know, delta function is this t equal 0, it's 1 pulse here, infinite. Okay, we call this a delta function. Then, how do we know x of omega? Means by formula, x omega equal minus infinity to infinite xt e power minus mt t. Now, x of t equal delta over t. Now, delta over t means, as you know, t equal 0. This value equal 1. Then t equal this 0, then this x integral equal 1. The graph is this. This is omega and plot frequency characteristics. And x omega equal 1 means this is omega, not t. Okay, omega 1. Then what is x over t? This is inverse Fourier transform. Then x of t equal 1 by 2 pi integral x of omega. Now x omega equal 1 e to omega t. Now this is, as I introduced the previous slide, this equal 2 pi delta t. Therefore, this 2 pi divided by 2 equal delta over t. Equal this. This means t equal 0, 1 pulse here. Okay, next. Delta function. This means it's discrete. Okay, or another way, all 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Yeah, delta function, delta of n. Then x omega, also by formula. This one. And x of n equal delta of n. Now this also n equal 0, this value equal 1. Therefore, this x omega equal 1. This, you can see this. This is omega, and all just flat. Then, x omega equal 1, what is x omega? This is inverse Fourier transform. Now here, omega, not n, okay? Yes. Then, x of n equal, by the formula here, then x omega equal this 1. From this, for integration, the range of integration omega equal 0 to range equal 0 to 2 pi. I have 0 to 2 pi here. Okay, and in the for integration, this one, n equal not 0, we can do this. And from this, we can get this value equal also 1. This value is also 1. 1 by 1 equals 0. This is equal 0. n is not equal 0. In case of n equal 1, this is 1, this is 1. Therefore, this is 1 equal this. That means this n equal 0. Amplitude equal 1. Otherwise, or 0, 0, 0, 0, this. And one exponential function, this one, is what? Now you can see your t means t equals 0 to infinity. Okay? Then the x omega means by the formula, this x t equal this one, and the integral, the range of integral equal minus infinity, infinity to 0 to infinity because of u over t. U equal t equal 0 to infinity, t equal 0. Then from this, we can integral here, this one, then finally, this equal 0, this equal 1. Then finally, we can get this. From this, we can get the magnitude of the spectrum. Now here, A equal 0.5. Okay, this is a magnitude. Okay, magnitude means 1 by A plus J omega. This is a phase spectrum, means 1 by A plus J omega phase angle. Okay, this is a omega. Omega equal basically minus infinity to infinity. Okay, this is for the source code for your reference. And in case of a discrete case. Okay, now here, your n equal this. This means n greater than 0. Greater than 0. Then this is of a of n. From this, x omega equal by formula, this. This x of n equal a of n. And u of n means n equals 0 to infinity. Then we can rearrange this one. This is the geometrical sequence with the geometrical ratio equal 0, that 1 by minus geometrical ratio. From this, we can get magnitude spectrum. Now this also a equal 0.5. Now you can see here, now 0 to pi is repeated. That is x omega equal x omega plus k times 2 pi. This is a periodical phase also, this one, 2 pi, same one. Now this is even signal, this is odd signal. Even function, odd function. Source code for your reference. And the rectangular function here, now this is x omega. Now here x omega equal, now here all 0 minus w2, 0 is equal 1. This is equal 1, equal rectangular omega by 2 pi. Then what is x of t? This is inverse Fourier transform. Then x of t equal by this, we can do this one, x of t equal 1. The range of integral is minus w to w. Now also, t is not equal to 0, then you can buy this. Then from this, you can get this kind of sinc function. And the t equal 0, equal t equal 0 is 1. Therefore, from this, this one. Okay, this is the waveform, waveform. This is this I Fourier transform. This waveform, w equal 2, 4, 6. Now you can see the rectangular function goes to sinc function, and also here you can see increasing the bandwidth is w 2, 4, 6 makes XT more sharp and dull. Sharper, go to sharper. Okay. Source code for your reference. And in this case, x n equal 1. That means this one. x is equal to 1 or 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, multiple to 0 이거. Then x is, what is x omega, Fourier transform. Okay, basically, this is not absolute integral. Therefore, for existing the Fourier transform, x over n less than infinite, not infinite, but in this case, x over n equal infinite. Therefore, not absolute integral. Therefore, Fourier transform of this is determined by the inverse Fourier transform of del omega. That means like this. For example, x over n could do this. Now x over n equal 1, this is 1. What we want to know is this one, how to know this. Then from this, okay, now, first of all, this term is 2 pi. 2 pi means, now, as already first slide of this lecture, I explained, said, in this case, this equal 2 pi del omega. Okay, now here, let's think one thing. Now, x omega, and the x omega plus k times over 2 pi. Of course, k equal integer. Then, summation x of n, this is omega, instead of omega, omega plus 2k by. Then we expand, then this term, and this term. Now you get this equal 1. Then this is what? This is x omega. Therefore, this term is the same, means this x omega is periodical with the period of 2 pi. Therefore, from this one also we can write this one, 2 pi, this one. This means omega equal 0, omega equal 2 pi, omega equal 4 pi, like this. This means that the first train, 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, like this. This is x of omega. Okay, thank you so much for your watching. Today I have explained Fourier transform and improved Fourier transform of Bayes signals. Those are delta function, continuous case of delta function, and discrete case. Exponential function, continuous and discrete case. And the rectangular pulse, this one. Next topic is first properties of a Fourier transform. First, I will explain the time shifting property and duality properties. Please look forward to the next lecture. Thank you so much again.